tonsils, that is lymphoid tissues. So lingual tonsils are there in the oropharynx. The tonsils are composed of lymphoid tissue and trap and destroy pathogens entering the body through oral and nasal cavities. The walls of the oropharynx is lined by stratified squamous epithelial cells. Laryngopharynx, the third one is laryngopharynx. It is the inferior and the oropharynx and posterior to the larynx. It is inferior to oro and posterior to larynx. It contains as a common root for air and food. This is also common root for air and food. Food comes from here, air comes from here in the laryngeal region. So both will come there. And at the inferior end of it, it gives the separate way for digestion, digestive and respiratory system. At the inferior portion, it gives two ways, here one way, here one way. This is for the digestive, this is for the air. This is for the digestive because this is the esophagus. So the food enters the esophagus, the air enters the trachea. The trachea is guarded by epiglottis, the flap. Epiglottis is there, the flap is there. Whenever food comes up till here, it will be closed and the food rushes in the esophagus. When the air comes here, it opens and the air goes inside the trachea. So this is about the respiratory system. It is lined by the stratified squamous epithelial cells as like in the oropharynx. Now tomorrow we will study about the larynx. Larynx is the third part. So first nasal cavity, pharynx we have learned. So larynx we'll take tomorrow and we'll study about the larynx tomorrow. Then comes trachea, bronchus, bronchioles and alveoli. So this is all about the respiratory system. So in the respiratory system, the organs involved are very important. You must by heart the organs involved. The first one is nose, nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchus, bronchiole, alveoli and diaphragm. Thank you very much.